at the age of 21. And Bordeaux is going to start this full of fireworks, as he always does. And these first few rounds are going to be the really testing moments for Joe Book. Like we knew he would, Bordeaux is going to try and nail him in the opening rounds. And he's giving Bugner more trouble in these opening few seconds of this fight than Henry Cooper did. First onslaught over gives Bugner time to rethink. And Bugner stands there and looks at him and wonders what's coming next. He must have been prepared for this. Everybody told him Bordeaux would start like this. But all the same, the pressure is really on this young champion. It really is almost cruel the way this Wembley crowd is willing Bordeaux to beat him. Keep him up to put George Smith, the referee. Bordeaux's done all the attacking in the opening round and has taken it. Well, everybody warned Joe Bugner what to expect from Bordeaux in the opening round, so he won't be too surprised. But the pressure bearing down on this 21-year-old British, European and Commonwealth heavyweight champion must be almost intolerable, because he must feel that it's not just Bordeaux he's got against him, but he's got thousands of people outside the ring, all of them against him as well. And the cry goes up now, not for Bugner, but for Bordeaux. Jack Bordeaux, 10 years older, and conceding exactly one stone in weight here, 14, 5.5 against Bugner's 15, 5.5. Bugner has got 6.5 inches reach advantage, and he's going to need it. The long reach of Bugner now beginning to tell a bit. And Bugner's getting this left jab working, and it's working well now. And he's written Bodell's face on the right-hand side. Got his elbow down to block that one. Bordeaux coming in open-mouthed, as he always does. And Bugner now beginning to slip inside the attacks of Bordeaux and countering well with the left. And this round will have given Bugner a lot of confidence. Bodell has come forward most of the time. He's done the chasing, but he hasn't scored quite as often as Bugner. And you must give this round by a shade to the champion. That's a hard round, and Bodell didn't do the forcing as much as he did in the first. Well, that's the opening ploys out of the way. Bodell made his effort in the first round, and he did take Bugner out of his stride, but not enough. Bugner's come back in the second with some good sharp punching and has begun to get the left jab to work. So now we've really got this thing on the road. Fourth British title fight. He won the vacant title when Cooper relinquished it by beating Carl Gidsey, and he had two losing fights with Cooper. Standing around waiting when perhaps he should be jabbing. Bodell feeling for him and finding him. That's a good body punch from Bugner. Left hand underneath. Got the makings of a very hard fight indeed, this one. They've both felt the weight of each other's punches. That's a good left jab from Bugner. Just as he got the cry from his corner, I could hear it right over here on the other side. They said, come on, to Bugner. They don't want him in there posing, they want him jabbing. Bugner still letting Bodell make the first moves. Champion tying up Bodell quite usefully inside. That's a good punch from Bodell. Left hand got through. Done a little more work here than Bugner, and I'd give him this round. This is the third full-scale title fight that Joe Bugner, still only 21, has had in 6 months. He beat Henry Cooper in March. In May, he defended the European title against Jürgen Blin. And now here he is again in the ring in a full-scale title fight, defending the British title against Jack Bodell. So now I've got Bodell just slightly ahead, a quarter of a point ahead on my card. Stuff. You can hear the cries again coming from Bugner's corner. Get that jab going. That's what he's got to do. He mustn't stand around. Bodell's 68th fight tonight. what the Bugner corner must be hoping is to get Joe successfully through these early few rounds and then hope that the 10 years difference in age will begin to tell against Bodell. And remember that Bugner has also got a stone in weight advantage. Underneath as Bodell went lunging in. He leaves himself so wide open with these swings. How about that then? Bugner felt confident enough to stand there and swap him with Bodell. I'd like to bet that wasn't in the instructions from the corner. Both these men having to really work for every point. He didn't move him at all, and that was a pretty even round there between those two. They both swapped punches, and it would be difficult to pick between them there, although Bodell was more aggressive. Left hands in, and he gets them in, Bodell. Henry Cooper said that Bodell will be the most awkward customer Bugner's ever faced, and he's dead right. Those punches come from angles that Bugner's probably never experienced before. We're over a minute into this fifth round, and Bugner's not settled down in it yet. Moving around the ring, circling the ring all the time, and not giving Bugner much of a target for the left hand. Bugner standing there very much at bay. Jabbing punches from Bodell, getting through to the head of Bugner. This is not a good round for the champion. Bodell picking him off now, more or less as he likes. And Bugner will have to do a lot better than this if he's going to keep the title. But we've still a long way to go. He's getting past the defense. This is a worse run for Bugner than the first. He's hardly laid a glove on Bodell. Bugner's not got his boxing going at all in this one. He's looked a sorry sight there. He's taken everything Bodell's handed out. A thoroughly bad round for the champion. Well, now they've got some problems in that corner because surely Andy Smith, his manager, must say to him, you've got to do a lot better than that if you're going to keep it, because many more rounds like that and Joe Bugner will be in serious trouble.
Second off, round six.
So now Bodell right on top with the initiative. Let's see what Bugner can do about it, because he surely must do something better than he did in that last one. He just can't get his arms working. He wants to do something, but he can't let the punches come. There's only one thing to do here for Bugner. He's got to pump that left hand out. That's his principal weapon, his best one. And he's got to keep that in Bodell's face. Round, getting home almost every attack, occasionally spurring Bugner into bursts of action, but Bugner looks jaded and very unhappy. It's clearly been Bodell's round. He's got through with every head attack he's thrown. And Bugner can do nothing but hold on. And that's another very clear one for Jack Bodell. And there's plenty of action in this fight, but very nearly all of it is coming from this man. Bodell at 31 is putting up the fight of his life here against Bugner, brimming with confidence now. He had a sticky second round, but apart from that, he's done almost everything right. And every attack he mounts now, no matter how wild it might be, and some of them come winging in from almost outside the ring, it doesn't matter, they get through. And Joe Bugner is dropping further and further behind, and he's got a lot to do to get back on level terms.
Round seven.
Somewhere, somehow, Joe Bugner, the 21-year-old champion, has got to pull his boxing together and get the jab working, otherwise he can say goodbye to the championship. It's quite incredible, really, with Bugner. He's like a statue in the ring, hardly throwing a punch. Nowhere near the performance he put on against Cooper. Now that's what he's got to do, and he better get going with it. Bugner's head, and it looks to me as though Bugner might have some sort of damage near his left eye, and that is a very rare thing with Bugner. Some sort of mark up there by that eye, Bugner, but it's nothing serious. It's been a slightly better run for the champion, but not that much. He's got his jab working occasionally. Seems almost to need a great effort of will for him to put that left hand out. That's a good punch. It's a better round for Bugner, and he's managed to stem the tide a little. It was going dead against him. He's been quite immobile tonight, Bugner. It's been amazing. He boxed very much better than this against Cooper. And really, he stood around like a statue tonight with Bodell, and he's let Bodell hit him with everything. I've got him 3/4 of a point down at this stage with 8 rounds left. So he's got to win 3 rounds to pull level.
Second out. Round 8.
When he does let that left jab go, it's a fair old punch. And he takes Bodell right off balance with it. Jabbed by a man with a much shorter reach. Everything now is likely to depend whether Bodell can keep the pace up. He's always been a very fit man. But he is 31, and he's 10 years older. And we're now only halfway through this fight. Bugner again has done very little in this round. good job Bugner can take a punch. Bo Dell is really coming after this title tonight. And it's another good round for the challenger. Now's the time he's got to start working. Easy, they're crying now for Bodell. And they're not far wrong at that. Bodell can't miss him. It doesn't matter what he swings. He really can't miss Bugner tonight. And you'd think that Bodell was the one a stone heavier. Bodell's cut on the face and he's cut underneath the left eye. It's not serious and it's not likely to hamper him. It's only a nick underneath Bodell's eye. Jack hasn't stopped putting punches together since the first bell. What a tribute to his fitness at 31. And you can mark that one down to Bodell as well. No panic in that corner, that cut's not bad, and it's underneath the eye, so it is not going to hinder his vision at all. But it's the first real sign of damage on either man's face.
Second up, 10-12.
So six to go, including this one, and Bodell further and further ahead. So now we've got to think in terms, if Bugner's going to win this fight, that he's going to have to stop this man because it's beginning to look very doubtful whether he can outpoint him. Two things tell the story of this fight so far. The relentless determination and sheer guts of Bodell in taking the fight to the younger man all the time. And this extraordinary immobility of Bugner, the continual posing, the standing there without pushing the punches out. He should have dominated it with the left hand and he hasn't done it. stop Bodell coming to him. Who puts the finishing touches to these little exchanges. Is there any chance that this young man can save his title? It's beginning to look very, very doubtful indeed. And in fact, it's astonishing when I look down at my card, I find I've only given him one round. I've given a couple even, and the rest have been Bodell's. And that'll give you some idea of the sort of lead that one assumes Bodell has set up. Mr. George Smith is the referee, and it matters what's on his card and not on mine. But surely, Bodell can only be a very, very long way ahead at this stage.
Take a
goal,
round 11.
So Bugner still on his feet, having taken a lot of punishment around the head from Bodell. Has he got it in him now to find something to stop the veteran from the Midlands taking his title away, taking three titles away? Bugner corner being cautioned by referee Smith for yelling instructions. Understandably, they must be getting a bit desperate. Left eye bleeding again. That left hand has found the target on Bugner's head over and over again tonight. Cut a little worse, but still dominating the exchanges, pushing Bugner around this ring as though he were a toy. Bugner just goes on standing there and taking it. Well, that looks as though it's going the distance. We've got four to go. But only a miracle now, surely, can prevent Bodell going back to the Midlands with these three titles. Flogging left hand, which has tormented Bugner all night, still crashes in to that blonde head as though it's drawn there by some invisible cord. Caught him with a left, but I think Jack was off balance. I don't know whether he was hurt, but he's holding on a bit. Bugner certainly caught him with the left hand. Could this be a turning point in the 12th? Bugner pulls this out, it'll be a miracle, and he's got him hurt. Two more left hands, and Bodell is hanging on. And we have got the makings of a major sensation here. Bugner's hurting him. And maybe the years are catching up with Jack Bodell. And Jack looks very tottery indeed. What an amazing thing this will be. And Bodell draws strength again from somewhere. But he's caught again and he's almost down. And we've got 50 seconds of this amazing round remaining. And Bugner has a chance to win. And can you believe that? He was pushed, but Bodell is having to hang on, and the years have suddenly caught up with him. One of the amazing rounds of the year, the left hand of Bugner, which had hardly been in evidence all night, caught Jack Bodell, and suddenly, from looking all over a winner, he was tottering all over the place. So now, what is going to happen? Can Bodell see these last three rounds out? In this 13th round, must just start throwing punches. He's seen his chance in the last round, and now he must cash in on it, if he can do it. His only chance. punches. Bugner's not letting the punches go. He did there, and he caught him two good ones. Now, why doesn't he do that more often? Bugner has not capitalized on the 12th round. He stood around too much and he's posed too much again, and his chance might have gone. So we've got two to go, and we saw in the 12th that it is still possible for Bugner to win this. He could perhaps still stop his man, and that's his only chance, because he's too far behind, on my card anyway, to win this on points. A very long way behind. So he's got to come out now and nail Bodell. And he's seen himself the way it can be done.
Second rope, round 40.
So it's do or die for Bugner if he's going to stop Bodell walking home with the titles. Through that sticky patch of the 12th, and here he is now in the 14th, still hunting his man and still looking reasonably fresh. My bet is that Bodell is very nearly drained of all his resources, because he's put everything into this fight and he's never stopped coming forward. Working loose from Bugner's right glove. Standing around again, and he's knocked the gum shield right out of Bodell's mouth and right down into our laps here. Now he's going, now he's working, but why hasn't he done it before? Just under a minute of this round to go, and Bugner again has a chance. Seconds of this round will go. He doesn't seem capable of setting up a sustained attack. Five, and there's the bell, and Bugner's been on the floor has put it beyond all further doubt. And Bugner in real trouble towards the end of the 14th round, up against the ropes, head down. Bodell comes in, the right falls short, and the left gets through. And Bugner tottering on the verge of defeat here, with only seconds of that round remaining, and what might have happened if Bodell had done that earlier. So 3 minutes of this amazing championship battle left. Bugner the one in trouble.
Second hope. Most round.
And Bugner's got to stop him to win now. He's either got to knock him out or stop him. But the way things went towards the end of the 14th, Bugner will be lucky if he doesn't get knocked out himself if Bodell mounts another attack like that. And this championship battle has had 10,000 people at Wembley on their feet. This must be the night of nights for Jack Bodell. Never fought better in his life. He came to take these titles, and it's 100-1 on now that he's going to take them. Bugner hanging on, doesn't know what to do. Down. We're halfway through the last, and it's ending in this wild slugging match. Bodell has only got to stand up to win. Less than a minute to go. And the reign of Joe Bugner as British champion virtually over. Joe Bugner, a gentle giant tonight, who's very, very seldom shown the fire of a champion. And he's trying now, but it's all too late. 8 seconds to go. And there's the bell, and there can only be one winner, and it's Jack Bodell. Champion of Britain for the second time. Champion tonight of the Commonwealth and of Europe, and he's got almost nothing left.
Gentlemen, please, the referee stills the contest. 71 and a half points to Bugner, 74 and three quarters.